Hey, I am Jelle, and I like to climb stuff. Some people say climbing and sitting behind your desk all day complement each other perfectly. But have those people actually ever tried pressing buttons after their hands look like this? So, I made a climbing game that you can control with eye tracking and voice control, so I won't have to touch anything ever again. Okay. So let's start with making the main character of our game. My years of climbing experience have allowed me to create the perfect climber. Big, strong hands and forearms, an enormous back, and teeny tiny shoes. I mean, how do these people even get their feet in there? Oh yes, and stylish hipster hair. Of course, how could I miss that? I rigged him up and created some open and closed hand animations. Because if there's one thing important in climbing, it's to keep your hands closed at the right time. With the climber finished, it was time to make the gameplay. Now, how would a climbing game even work? Well, let me explain. Okay, so you play as a climber, and you want to send the route. You do this by looking at the hold you want, and then scream which hand you want to move. Left! Right! Right! Left! Do this over and over and over again, and you are at the top in no time. Let's build a game! Now that you know what to do, it is coding time! I knew I had to use some sort of physics to simulate the movement of the climber, like these cool other games. I started with a ragdoll setup, so every limp would go limp. And then I could send the hands to the desired location. Okay, looks promising. Oh no, that's not what I want. Time for something different. Luckily, Unity has some built-in IK controls. So similar to my biking game, I could use goals for my hands and feet where they would try to get to. But of course, that way there's no physics simulation. It just looks unnatural. That was the exact moment I had the luminous idea. What if I make the goals themselves physics-based objects and connect them to the body with some digital springs? Look at those dandy legs, so realistic. I did the same thing for the hands and apply the force to them when I click on a hold in the direction of that hold. If the hand reaches the hold, the climber would grab on for dear life. Of course, everyone gets tired of holding on with just one hand, so you have to be quick, or else. After the core gameplay was done, I created a fancy climbing gym with cool neon lights and a big fall mat. Maybe it won't help that much when you fall 30 meters, but hey, it's the idea that counts. Try to reach the top as fast as you can, but be careful not to miss your hold, or you might end up like this guy. You see, the game was fun to play and all, but it was kind of difficult to control. I mean, have you ever tried pressing the left and right mouse buttons with your chin? I needed a better way to control the game. Let's fire up the eye tracker.
What? I haven't made it yet? Oh,
let's build an eye tracker. Okay, so eye tracking is pretty difficult to pull off, and it becomes even more difficult without dedicated hardware. Luckily, I have the perfect thing, my iPad. It has a 3D depth sensor in the front that I use all the time to scan stuff, like my face. But I don't need to scan anything. Right now, I need to track my eyes. Unity has a nice package that has support for face tracking on Android and iOS. It's the same technology you use to create your hip memojis. The first thing the framework does is look for my face. After the program finds it, I can find my eye's positions and rotations in relation to my face, which stands in relation to the camera. You see, it's all connected. But just the eye information was not enough. I need to know where I'm looking at the screen. So, hear me out. I created a virtual iPad screen that is configured to match the physical dimensions of the device that is being used. I get the orientation of my device to determine where the camera is supposed to be in relation to my virtual screen, to either left, right, up or down. Then, I shoot out rays straight out of my eyes and track where they hit on the virtual screen. Those two points are then averaged to get center point to estimate my focal point. When I get that point, I perform an inverse rotation on the offset in relation to the center of the virtual screen to get precise x and y coordinates of the hit points. After scaling the values from the physical dimensions to pixel dimensions, I display a red dot on the calculated location on the screen. After all of that, it didn't work at all. Unless there was someone standing behind me who is being tracked. But after a lot of hard work, determination, and a little bit of luck, I had a working eye tracker. Hell yeah! Having an eye tracker is cool, but I had no way to do anything after that. I mean,
I could stare very hard at the hold, but the only thing that would happen is my eyes would start to hurt. So, I implemented voice commands using the built-in speech frameworks from iOS, which I could use with this very nice plugin from this fine GitHub account. I could listen for certain words. I set up the game to listen to left and right. So when I look at a certain hold and say left, the climber's hand would try to reach the hold with his left arm. And just the same for the right hand. I also implemented a rest command for when you get tired. But we all know there is no resting in the middle of a boulder, so yeah, you just fall down. Okay, so now I have everything to make the game work. Ready for the most amazing experience of your life?
Hands are ready, let's go. Let's start the game. Right. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Left. Grab, grab, grab. Left. We're going. Left. Right. Left. Left. Right. And left. Left. Woo! Level 1 complete, without any hands.
I am so happy right now. I can finally climb even when my hands are totally destroyed. And you can share in my fun as well. I might release this on iOS at a later date, but in the meantime, you can play it right now with your mouse on itch.io, because your hands probably just work fine. Or just play with your chin, you know. Be sure to leave a like if you want my hands to feel better after all the neglect. And subscribe if you want to see more videos in the future. And I'll see you guys next time, when it's again Game Jam time.